Hello everyone, tomorrow we will be witnessing the full moon, which will take place on the third degrees of Aries, third degrees of Libra. The moon will be in Libra, the sun will be in Aries. The degrees where Saturn is joyful. Saturn is the hidden place of Saturn. Degrees of justice, degrees of truth. And this is very important full moon because the future eclipses of the year 2022 are happening on the axis of Libra. Aries also, so much is happening. Also the lunar nodes will be transiting from March 23rd, 2022 for 18 months in the same two signs, Aries, Libra. So very much enhanced axis of hostilities, yes, or not, or just drive to achieve your goals, just drive to live to. And also what Libra represents, it is, of course, justice or lack of justice. So this will be important. Now, the good thing is that there are friendly aspects, you know, of Mars, Venus, and what is very, which will bring some kind of practical, maybe we'll see, I hope on the good energy of Jupiter, who in the very same moment, on the 18th of April, on the 17th is the full moon. On the 18th of April, Jupiter is entering Pisces. This is not, of course, aspecting the full moon degrees, but still overall, we look at every single detail in the horoscope. We'll start bringing a bit more positive energies, which we've been missing for so long. So, yes, full moon in the degrees where Saturn, the hidden place of Saturn, and actually the sun is in degrees which are called pure in astrology. Pure means that they're white because they're ruled by Athena, degrees of wisdom. Well, certainly all what is happening is if we manage to read properly the signs and to derive the right knowledge and wisdom from everything that is happening, then everything is just perfect for us. So let's see what is happening. Now, we are starting with the 18th of April, 15th lunar day. Of course, full moon, actually on this full moon is very good. You can see it or even plant. Because here in my country, for example, on the Balkans, people always choose the full moons to seed, to plant their seeds, to put the first seed before if the true planting. So this is very benevolent thing. And also during full moon, especially this one, it's not appropriate to do medical interventions. Here, just another thing to remind you. We have from the moment of the moon is starting to wane. Yes, from here we can derive some good dates for medical interventions, but not really for new beginnings. Not really, because for new beginning, we need very young moon, like the first lunar crescent or some lunar specific lunar days, because we need potentials, we need the youth of the moon. So let's see what is the moon appropriate for. You can travel, medical interventions are not yet. A very good day for some, because Mercury is visible as an evening star. So you can do a lot of studies. So you will have probably the motivation, especially if you get the blessing of Mercury. You can teach others, do media work. This would be very, very appropriate and is happening in very specific degrees in Aries, very driven also. Now, so this is one thing. This is Monday, 18th of April. Is Monday. You can welcome the sun. You know, the moon is ruling the day. And if you imagine the aura of health and abundance and fertility around you to be green or light blue, you can wear aquamarine on this day. Then we have 19th of April, which is Tuesday, 16th lunar day. The moon is in the vicinity of the Northern Crown, very powerful star, which is giving visibility in what we do. This is good for imagination, for writers, for students, for people who study, share their knowledge with others. Great day for beauty procedures. Great day for creating beauty, for talented work. You can even travel. Yes, you may. Also, medical interventions, not really. If not invasive, you can. It is Tuesday, day of Mars. You welcome the sun. You imagine healthy red aura around you, which is giving you drive and health and energy, and you can wear a ruby. Then we have 20th of April, 17th lunar day. The moon is in hermetic degrees of knowledge, really hermetic, very interesting degrees of knowledge. You can research, do natural sciences, plant, gather herbs, especially for herbal activities, for homeopathy, for people who practice homeopathy, doctors. This is really beautiful degree. Medical interventions, really not. It is Wednesday, day of Hermes. You can welcome. You can even still see Mercury Hermes on the evening sky. You can do this just before the sun completely sets. It is just between the setting of the sun and the rays of the moon when you'll be able to see Mercury on the western horizon. You can imagine you welcoming the sun. Imagine the aura around you to be green, lemony, and you can wear emerald on this day. Great day for knowledge, practicing your spiritual activities, medical, natural sciences. Very nice. I'm talking about the real science, not about the contemporary science, excuse me. So we have then 21st of April, 18th lunar day. The moon is conjoined, very powerful star, very successful, star of the army lead, star of people who are very professional in what they do, experts. Again, it will be about advancing in career. So any important career steps, but more towards finalizing than new beginnings. It could be very good again for practicing herbalism, planting, replanting, natural sciences, medical interventions, not. You can travel on this day. It is Thursday, you welcome the sun, you know, Jupiter is ruling this day, and you can imagine him and the aura around you could be orange, yellow, and you can wear citrine, for example. On this day, what else you can do? Certainly no medical interventions. You can do some arrange your work, arrange your career, leadership practices would be very nice. Train your courage and self-confidence. Beautiful. Then we have April 22nd. It is Wednesday. The moon is in a very powerful position in the point of the winter solstice. Making very good harmonious aspect to the sun, very harmonious day to train your emotions to reach self-confidence, self-esteem. You can do medical interventions, you can travel, you can teach others, you can study. This is Friday, day of Venus. You welcome the sun, you know Venus is ruling the day. You imagine aura around you, light blue or pink, and you can wear pink quartz. So this is very nice. And you can travel, you can do a lot on this day. Then we have 23rd of April, Saturday, day ruled by Saturn. Here the moon also makes very good harmonious aspect with the still visible Mercury, so you still have the chance to see Mercury on the evening sky. And it is Saturday, you welcome the sun, you know Saturn is ruling the day. And you can even work on this day, you know, to pray Saturn to make sure that you have his good blessing, you know, because he's the Lord of Karma. And you can wear amethyst on this day. You can travel, you can negotiate, you can do medical interventions on this day. you can do things which involve finalizing, finishing your some tasks, closure of business tasks, and so on. Then we have Sunday, 24th of April, 21st of Nisan, 21st lunar day. Critical a bit, we have to be cautious. No medical interventions. The moon is in a very specific degree, a bit malefic, but very good for spiritual occultistic practices. Very good for, teaching, arranging your business, building work, finishing of some building work, arranging your home, let's say administration work, but more towards completion, or putting in order your keeping in arranging your paperwork, bookkeeping. Also, no medical interventions, to travel carefully. It's a critical 21st lunar day. Sunday, you welcome the sun. You imagine the aura around you to be orange, and you can expose your spine to the sun, and you will imagine that you're very healthy, that all this energy goes through your spine, and you can wear garnet on this day. Then we have 25th of April, which is Monday, 22nd lunar day. Again, the moon is in very specific degrees of Capricorn, so not really very appropriate to travel, to do medical interventions, to negotiate. No, but to do any work which involves knowledge and the blessing of visible Mercury as an evening star, this is great. You can see Mercury as an evening star, still will be visible. It is Monday, day of the moon. You welcome the sun, and you see around yourself the aura you imagine to be light green, and you can wear Larimar or pearls, but the degrees of them not good for medical interventions. If you travel, you may actually, but make sure that you're very well prepared. You can do finalizing of bookkeeping, building, you can do arranging your home. Then we have 26th of April, which is Tuesday, 23rd lunar day again. Very interesting spiritual degrees for healing, for practicing medical practices, for teaching others, learning, finalizing business, putting your business in order, your bookkeeping, arranging, all this. It is Tuesday, you welcome the sun, again you receive healthy red aura energy, which will bring you exactly energy, power, drive, and you can now Mars is ruling your day, so you have the drive of Mars, and you can wear red stone like carnelian, for example. And yes, this day you may do medical interventions, you may travel, but it's good for completion of things, for completing your let's say some tasks or projects or business, arranging paperwork, like that. Then we have Wednesday, 26th of April. Again, waning moon, completion of the month. Medical interventions you may do. Travel, actually, you may. Completing of business tasks or paperwork, building work is very good. It is day of Wednesday. It is a day of Mercury, Hermes. He's still visible. So you can welcome the sun, and you know that Mercury is ruling the day. So the aura around you to be yellow, green, and you can wear emerald. Then we look at, 1 second to see the exact degree of the moon. Yeah? Yes, it is Thursday, 28th of April, 25th lunar day. The moon applies to Venus, very good. Very good for beauty procedures, very good for planting in the waning moon is not replanting, let's say. It is very good. You can travel, you can do medical interventions, teaching others, sharing knowledge with others. It's a day of Jupiter, so you welcome the sun. You know, the aura around yourself is yellow, and you can wear yellow sapphire. It's a very good day because the moon applies to Venus, to aspect with Venus. So this is about the Thursday. And then we have Friday. And actually, I think, yes, this is the last lunar day. If you really want to close something, to complete, it is a good day. Friday, day of Venus, you welcome the sun. You imagine around yourself very pink, white, pure aura. And you can wear pink quartz. The day is very good, actually, for, let's say, teaching others, for medical interventions, if they don't involve anesthetics, if they don't involve putting you asleep. You can do beauty procedures. But again, this is the last lunar day. If there is something that you want to get rid of, like you have something that you want to remove, something minor, beauty procedures, you may, medical interventions, I told you what types of medical interventions you may do. You can work on your garden, and when the moon was waning, you could do all these vegetables, which rooty vegetables. So what else about this? And then we will have the 3 days invisibility of the moon, and you know, on the 30th we have the eclipse. And now I will post also my other video on the eclipse, so you can see how I see it. And all the best. See you very soon.